One of the important aspects in astronomy is actually recording the position of something on the sky. Most things have kind of fixed coordinates from an astronomical point of view, although even faraway stars, they have something we call a proper motion. It means that they will move just ever so much every year. But most objects have kind of fixed right ascension and declinations. And I'll refer back to the things you can see here on my right, which have to do with coordinate systems. And it's not surprising that astronomy still uses the fact that you're sort of at the center of the universe from our perspective, and we're mapping things in essentially spherical coordinates, but most of the time we don't even need to know the distance, and therefore we typically define the coordinates as theta and phi. If you remember things from physics 101 or even 115, where you covered spherical coordinates, again, there will be an angle that will measure the position equivalent to the xy axis, and then an angle that will essentially go north and south. And there will be, in astronomy, the right ascension, which goes essentially on the xy coordinate system, and north-south will be declination. So right ascension in astronomy, and one of the things that you should note is how it is measured. Positive direction, as you can see here as well, is measured eastward, not westward. And that is because essentially when you're looking at the Earth, you're typically looking at it from a space perspective and we're looking down. In this case, we're actually looking up from the Earth. And therefore the convention is when you move east, you're adding to the right ascension. This is essentially analogous to the longitude on the Earth's surface, and it is measured in hours. And therefore, typically coordinates are given in hour, minute, and second, even though sometimes we also measure them in degrees. Because they're measured in hours, the allowed range is essentially from 0 to 24 hours. And the 0 hour is defined essentially with the vernal equinox. So right ascension essentially measures the angle up and down. Up will be positive for the northern hemisphere. Down will be negative for the southern hemisphere. It is an angle that is reported typically in degrees above this right ascension plane of XY, as you can see here. If you're all the way in the North Pole, your declination will be plus 90. If you're in the South Pole, your declination will be minus 90. Because the right ascension is typically given in hours, minutes, and seconds of hours, and the declination is given in degrees, minutes of degrees, and seconds of degrees, or something called arcseconds, it is very good to know, as you see here, just above me, the transformations from this hexadecimal system to the degree sort of decimal system, which is used in a lot of coding and also to send telescopes sometimes to those locations. And just to make sure that you are familiar with how you would tackle this and how you'd convert, I've included both in the lecture notes and here an example of how we would convert the coordinates for this galaxy right here, that's Cosmos Redshift 7. And the coordinates in the hexadecimal system, you can see here, this is the declination. On the other side, you have right ascension. And right ascension is given hours, minutes, seconds, and declination, degrees, arc minutes, arc seconds. And when you look at maybe coordinates of stars, planets, or galaxies, coordinates will typically look like this. And now hopefully you know what they mean. If you need to convert them to the decimal system, all you need to do is to apply the coordinate transformations you have above. This is relatively simple. So for the right ascension, the only thing you really should remember is that because coordinates are given in hours, you will need to multiply by 15. That is essentially 360 divided by 24 hours. While for declination, you don't need to do that. And therefore, you're just converting the contributions from the seconds or arc seconds to the arc minutes and then the degrees to get it to a value which is decimal. And I hope that is clear. There is also at least one example in the lecture notes where you can apply this again. In terms of coordinates and coordinate systems, there are actually quite a lot of them to do with whether you're studying the galaxy, just the solar system, or something else, and you can transform between those coordinate systems. But one thing that is important to actually note is that the sky or the stars are not really fixed. And because we're moving around a galaxy and there's also a precessional cycle, it is important to note that these constellations that you can see here, they actually move by about one, or more like minus one, every 26,000 years. And this means that if you have friends that really are keen into astrology and somehow believe in it, I don't know if that's possible, but if that is the case, you should probably do some outreach and tell them that they do need to update their essentially constellations by minus one. This means that even if they think they are some sort of a Capricorn, because the sun was in Capricorn when they were born, very likely that was not the case. And it was probably in the constellation before. Or maybe you think you're an Aquarius because the sun was in that position when you were born. Very likely it was actually in Capricorn. And obviously we can do that, and it's very easy to go back in time with models. And you can even check how the sky was when you were born. Not that that should affect your personality at all.